we look forward to sharing this this initiative with everyone who's involved, and also making an impact within communities. As you know, when you invest in a woman's future, you invest in changing lives. Thank you.
We're here with one of the founders in Uganda. It's very shocking to find that a male, one of the males, decided to start this campaign. What made you want to start this campaign, not do something for boys?
So, more than anything, we were inspired by a story that we read in the Woman 24 article. Basically, the lady, the homeless lady, was living under the footbridge and was very embarrassed to tell her boyfriend of the situation of needing to buy pants every month and she couldn't afford. So after reading that, we discussed it as well amongst friends, as guys, as well as, you know, people involved. Kind of just discussing, is there really a need for this? We also ended up doing research, and then we saw that, look, this is something, this is a real need in South Africa. So because of that, we then put upon ourselves to take responsibility, and yeah, that's where we are right now. And it's only the beginning.
Women make up 51% of the population in South Africa. There is no such thing as a woman's issue. It is the country's issue. As Thando said earlier, of 2.1 million girls between the ages of 12 to 21 in the rural areas of South Africa miss up to 60 days of school in a year. And this is because they do not have sanitary towels or cannot afford sanitary towels. And it is economic inequality when a woman in general is paid less than men, but is still expected to pay for sanitary supplies.
I'm standing here with Nongozi from Power FM. We're out here today in Bakwazi for the hashtag Protest for Change. How are you doing?
My contribution could actually help someone, even if not directly knowing that it was me.